This is a gift from my father-in-law. It is a supply of glucosamine and chondroitin for a whole year. He is taking 2 tablets a day for the past year, and he said he noticed a big pain relief in his knee pain, which is due to osteoarthritis. A lot of people ask my opinion about glucosamine and chondroitin for osteoarthritis. So in this video, I'll give you my honest opinion. The scientific evidence is not too exciting, but it seems that glucosamine and chondroitin have some role to play in the treatment of osteoarthritis. So today, let's talk about osteoarthritis, glucosamine, and chondroitin supplements. Osteoarthritis is a chronic, slow-progressing, insidious disease of the cartilage that covers the bone surfaces. We have cartilages in most of the joints of our body, including the knees, the hips, the shoulders, elbows, fingers, temporomandibular joint, and even the spine. This is the knee. The cartilage is a part that protects the bones from rubbing against each other. When osteoarthritis starts, it destroys the cartilage and causes pain, stiffness, and deformity. When osteoarthritis affects the spine, we call it spondylosis. Osteoarthritis is a progressive disease caused by a slow and microscopic inflammation. The destruction of the cartilage can be seen in x-rays like this. Here is the knee. You can see the tibia, the fibula, and you see the reduced space between the femur and the tibia. That's because of the destruction of the protective cartilage. Here is an x-ray of the hinge with osteoarthritis, and we can see the deformities caused by arthritis. Osteoarthritis is mostly determined by your genetics. So if you have a family member with osteoarthritis, your chances are higher to develop this disease. But there are other factors also that accelerate the process, and they include obesity, smoking, trauma to the joint, and other joint diseases like rheumatoid arthritis. We know that there are a few things that we can do to slow the progression of osteoarthritis, and these include regular, low-impact physical activity, weight loss, and adequate nutrition with an anti-inflammatory diet. Scientists are trying to find a medication that would stop the progression of osteoarthritis. We know that anti-inflammatories are effective medications to reduce the pain from osteoarthritis. These are medications like ibuprofen, diclofenac, ketoprofen, or celecoxib. But we know that anti-inflammatories have side effects like gastrointestinal bleeding, and they're also contraindicated in people who have heart disease, high blood pressure, or kidney insufficiency. So scientists discovered that there is a substance in the joint called glucosamine, and it's important to maintain the healthy cartilage. There is another substance called chondroitin that is a component of the cartilage. So it seems that if you ingest glucosamine and chondroitin, or both, the cartilages in your body will become healthier. However, the destruction of the cartilage, once it starts, it's very hard for the body to heal itself and make new cartilage. We know that the cartilage is nurtured by the synovial fluid that is produced by the capsule. And if we move that joint, more synovial fluid is produced, therefore bringing more natural nutrition to the cartilage. How does our body produce our own glucosamine and chondroitin? The answer is movement. If we use the joint properly, with proper exercises, we will produce our own glucosamine and chondroitin. I have another video where I show exercises for osteoarthritis of the hips and knees, and I explain that motion is lotion. So do we actually need to ingest more glucosamine and chondroitin to nurture the cartilage in our joints? Well, there are 2 types of glucosamine. Glucosamine sulfate that can be derived from natural sources like shellfish, but it can also be made in laboratory. And the other type is glucosamine hydrochloride. Some clinical trials compared one to another and did not find any difference in efficacy. However, some people would suggest that the natural sources are better absorbed by the body. However, People with allergies to shellfish or seafood need to be careful. How much glucosamine and chondroitin a person need to take to feel the benefits, and for how long? Well, those are very good questions, because it takes months for the benefits of glucosamine and chondroitin to be noticed. It is not like a painkiller that you take now and you start feeling feeling better in a few hours. However, did you know that there are some people who should not be taking glucosamine? I'll talk about this at the end of this video. So let's talk about the dose. To be effective, a person needs to take 1,500 milligrams of glucosamine per day and 1,200 milligrams of chondroitin per day. The studies that showed that these drugs are beneficial, they said that the person needs to be taking them for 6 months, and taking both together is better. However, there are some studies that showed no real difference from placebo. The results of the various studies are conflicting. So how will you know if this works for you or not? Well, basically you need to do a before and after trial on yourself. Always talk to your doctor or pharmacist before you start taking these supplements. So before your first dose that you are going to take, you are going to measure your pain. You can download these 4 questions from a document that I posted below this video. Go to the description of the video and check the link below that says 4 questions about pain intensity. And don't forget to print 2 copies, because you're going to need one now and one in 6 months. Or you can get a piece of paper now and write these 4 questions. So question number 1. In the last 24 hours, rate your pain by circling only one number that best describes your pain at its worst. 0 is no pain, and 10 is the pain as bad as you can imagine. Question number 2. In the last 24 hours, rate your pain by circling only one number that best describes your pain at its best, or the least pain that you had in the past 24 hours. 0 is no pain, and 10 is the pain as bad as you can imagine. Question 3. In the last 24 hours, rate your pain by circling only one number that best describes your pain on average. 0 is no pain, and 10 is pain as bad as you can imagine. And question 4. Rate your pain by circling only one number that best describes your pain right now, where 0 is no pain and 10 is pain as bad as you can imagine. After you answer these questions, fold this paper, put inside an envelope, date it, fold the other page that you're going to need in 6 months from now, and store it in a place that you're going to remember. Now you can start taking the glucosamine with chondroitin. Take them every day for about 6 months. Then you're going to complete the 4 questions again. So 6 months later, do you still remember where you put the envelope? Don't look at the answers. Get the second page, answer the 4 questions, and now you can open the envelope and compare the 2 before and after and do these calculations. How will you calculate if the treatment has been effective for you or not? You will add all the numbers that you gave before the trial. So let's say that you said 10 to all of 4 questions. Your score before the trial is 40. Now you're going to add the numbers that you gave after 6 months. Let's say that your numbers were all 8 for everything. The total is 32. You're going to get a calculator and divide 32 by 40, that's 0.8 or 80%. Now you subtract 100% minus 80% and you get 20% pain relief. 20% is the minimum that you need to achieve to say that this treatment has been effective for you. Why 20%? Because that's the number that the scientists chose to randomize people and show that glucosamine and chondroitin was effective to reduce pain. In a large multi-center study conducted in the United States, they set the threshold of 20% as the minimum that a person had to improve to be considered a good response. In the glucosamine chondroitin arthritis intervention trial, or GATE, this is what they found. 64% of people who took glucosamine achieved the 20%, the threshold of 20% pain relief. That's good, isn't it? 65% of people who took chondroitin sulfate achieved that threshold. Wow. What do you think happened when they gave both glucosamine and chondroitin? The number of people that achieved the threshold was 67%. And then there was another arm of people that took anti-inflammatory celecoxib, and 70% of that group achieved the threshold. Now pay attention. What do you think was the percentage of people that achieved the 20% pain relief with placebo? Placebo is a pill that doesn't contain any medicine in it, but the person thinks that they are taking the real drug. Well, it was 60%. In the same study, they found that the group of people with more severe knee osteoarthritis responded better. So among the group of people who had moderate to severe pain at the start of the study, these are the proportions of those who had at least 20% pain relief. 66% for glucosamine only, 61% for chondroitin only, 79% when they took both combined, 69% for celecoxib anti-inflammatory, and 54% for placebo. So you see, if your pain reduction is less than 20% after 6 months, you can stop wasting your money and invest on something else that might be much better, like buying high quality, extra virgin, olive oil, cold press, that has a lot of other substances that are very healthy for the cartilage, to maintain your healthy cartilage. Well, but both glucosamine and chondroitin are relatively safe, which means that they don't cause serious adverse effects like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or opioids. However, glucosamine and chondroitin can interact with blood thinners like warfarin or coumadin. They can also affect blood sugars. There is some suggestion that they may increase the eye pressure, which could increase the risk for glaucoma. So if you use warfarin, or if you have diabetes or glaucoma, it is better to avoid the substances or talk to your doctor or pharmacist before you start using them. If you have suggestion for any supplement that you'd like me to review in a video, just write down your suggestions in the comment box below. I already have another video about vitamin D and magnesium. Please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is any medical emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. If you like this video, give a thumbs up down there, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Bye!